You get a landmark. You get a landmark. Everybody gets a landmark. Yes, the card reveal season continues in Legends of Runeterra, and today it's pretty much all about landmarks. We got more reveals from the final Call of the Mountain expansion, which will be called Cosmic Creation, set to release on December 16th. In all seriousness, not every card spoiled today was a landmark, but some of these are pretty interesting, so let's talk about them. Before we jump in, if you like this type of content and want to see more, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any future coverage from me. Also, a quick shout out to Cosmic for putting this graphic together. Be sure to check out his Twitch channel in the top right, and I'll leave a card with a link to his YouTube channel in the top right as well. Let's start off with Monastery of Hirana. This is a 3-mana landmark that reads, round start, create a sanctuary in hand. Sanctuary is a 1-mana burst spell that's ephemeral that recalls an ally, and it can't be cast in combat or in response to a spell. Ionia gets its first landmark, and it's an interesting one. On paper, this doesn't look that powerful, but the idea behind this card is that you want to pair it with units that have effects that happen when you either play them from hand or when they're summoned, and ideally, they should be cheap to play. Obviously, this card, like some of the other cards shown today, will likely point to synergies with the next champion that will be revealed. But there are a few existing decks that could utilize this. Yasuo is the most obvious one. Ever since Shadow Assassin got nerfed, Yasuo decks haven't had much to do on round 3, so this could be nice for them. I don't think Shadow Isles is the best pairing for this card, because while Shadow Isles does have a ton of units with on-summon effects, they're also typically more expensive to play from hand, like the Rekindler and even Chronicler of Ruin. There are other regions with cheap units that have good summon effects, but quite a few of those regions don't typically pair with Ionia when using a recall strategy. Omenhawk from Freljord is a pretty good example. There is one deck I'm interested in though, and that's Lee Sin, particularly Lee Sin with Bilgewater. I don't know if this will replace Retreat, but this has excellent synergy with the Attune units from both regions, and in particular, Coral Creatures, who has Attune and a summon ability. Even Eye of the Dragon can be pretty insane with this card. The problems are going to be Fearsome decks, and whether or not playing Lee Sin and Bilgewater will finally be worth it over Targon. So far it hasn't been, but we'll see. Next we have Boomship. This is a 3-mana slow spell that deals 1 to a unit, then summon powder kegs equal to the amount of damage dealt. It's pretty obvious where this card wants to be played, and that's with decks that utilize damage from spells along with kegs. These are decks like TF Swain, TF Ezreal for those that still play it, and certain Gangplank decks. This also has synergy with Funsmith. The Siren and the Dreadway work with this card, but they're very slow units and I doubt this card makes them any more viable. This is another card whose design forces you to build your deck a certain way to make the card better. On its own, Boomship is bad. Despite that, I don't think this is the worst card shown today. After all, you do end up with more powder kegs than you started with after using this card, even if you didn't have any kegs to begin with. Next, we have the Scargrounds. This is a 3-mana landmark that reads, when an ally survives damage, grant it +1/+0 and tough. Freljord gets another landmark, and in my opinion, this is the more exciting one shown today. I think someone was thinking about Braum Vladimir decks when they designed this card and wanted to show the deck some love. I can't see this card being used in anything outside of a Vladimir strategy of some kind. I've said it before, but the tough keyword goes a long way when playing Vladimir. This has synergy with the most popular Crimson units, as well as cards like Unscarred Reaver and Scarmother Vrenna. Also, this card will still activate even if your unit ends up taking no damage from whatever hit them. The game only cares about whether or not it survived damage, even if that damage is 0. I'm not saying this is finally going to be the card that puts Braum Vlad decks on the map, especially since historically, no matter what cards or buffs Vladimir seems to get, he still ends up being bad, but this is another tool for them that's at least decent. Next we have Homecoming. This is a 5-mana fast spell that reads, recall an ally unit or landmark to recall an enemy unit or landmark. I'm having a hard time justifying this card with what we know right now. I think without knowing what the champion and the rest of the cards that'll be revealed tomorrow actually do, this is the worst card shown today. Even worse than Boomship. But again, we're in the dark when it comes to the rest of the cards that haven't been revealed yet. Aside from that, I don't see why anyone would play this over Will of Ionia, which also doesn't see play anymore since it got nerfed to 5 mana. The only way you'd play Homecoming over Will is in a landmark heavy meta, which could still happen, but it just hasn't. At least not yet. Next we have Wiggly Burblefish. This is a 6 mana 3-1 with elusive that reads, reduce my cost by 1 for each spell you've cast this game. When I'm summoned, create a 1 cost spell from your regions in hand. This is another card I'm interested in trying out in a Bilgewater Lee Sin deck. I didn't mention it earlier, but for those that have watched my content for a while, there was a Fizz Lee Sin deck I messed with for a little while right in the middle of the Targon Lee Sin combo meta, and it packed Mind Meld as a finisher. This is a card you definitely pair with Mind Meld, Fizz, and a bunch of cheap spells or cards that create additional spells for you to use. Whether that should include Lee Sin or not will remain to be seen. But I'm definitely experimenting with this idea once the expansion hits. I don't think this card works anywhere outside of that specific strategy, which is fine. There are plenty of one-trick pony cards in Legends of Runeterra, and every other card game for that matter, and while they're definitely not my favorite cards, they aren't a bad thing either, and I'd argue are still necessary to have. And finally we have It That Stares. This is an 8 mana 8-8 unit that reads, play, obliterate all landmarks, or deal 2 to all other units. I would say that as far as competitive play is concerned, this card is a meta call. The second ability is probably going to be the one most commonly used, but even an avalanche type of effect late game can have some impact. 2 damage does eliminate some breakpoints for damage, meaning your other units will be able to trade with enemy units they normally wouldn't be able to trade with after this comes down. And you get an 8-8 body on top of that. It doesn't have an additional keyword that lets it get past blockers or protect itself, but this card isn't that bad. It trades with Captain Farron, among other things. Again though, this card will very likely be a meta call, and we won't see it much outside of those specific metas where this card is good. And that's all I've got for now. I hope you enjoyed this look into the new cards that were revealed today. If you did, feel free to leave a like, as it really helps me out and gets this video out there to others in the community. If you don't want to miss future coverage of the new set from me, subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the notification bell below to make sure you know when the next video goes live. Feel free to check out the other Legends of Runeterra videos that I have on the channel, or even the other places you can find me on the internet. You'll find links to my Twitter, Twitch channel, and our community Discord that you can join as well in the video description below. Thanks for taking time out of your day to watch this, and I'll see you next time. Take care.